All right, if you just finished creating a Google Doc and you want to share it with other people, maybe you want to share it with other people just so that they can see it, or maybe you want them to be able to work alongside you. We're going to go through the different ways that you can share and the different permission levels in order to get the right thing done. So right now we're going to act like we're done with this document. We'll go in the upper right hand corner and left click on the blue share icon. And when you do that, you get a dialog that comes up in the middle of the screen. And you have two sections here. You have share with people and groups, and you have get a link. So first we'll talk about sharing with people and groups. And what this does is allows you to set the sharing settings for specific people or groups that you name. So let's say I want to share it with someone called Michael. I'll start typing him in. And all of my contacts come up as I type. And then Michael eventually comes up. I'll left click on him. And there's a drop down to the right where I get to select from the three different levels of permissions. So the first one, if I just want him to be able to see it and nothing else, would be viewer. If I want him to be able to see it, but also leave me comments, not actually typing into the document, but actually using the comment function, you would give him this level. And the next level is editor, which gives you full permissions to the document. We'll just leave this as editor for now. And the second thing is that this Michael, he's not going to know that you shared this with him unless you leave a check mark in here that says notify people. And this is going to send an email to him. So you could say something like, can you please proof this document? You just want him to check it out. Leave that check mark on. And if you left click on send, it will send Michael an email with a link that he can go to the document. Now, if I take a look at Michael's Google Drive, if you go in the upper right hand corner, you can see I'm logged in here as Michael. And let's go over and left click on shared with me, and you'll see the document that I just shared. So he can left click on this and open it up, and you can see now that two people are in it. Let me click OK here. Two people are in it. I see my face as the other account. I can see where my cursor is, me being Michael right now. It's in black, but I can also see where my other account is. So what I'll do to make this a little bit more apparent, I'll take Michael's document. I'll put it on the right, or Michael's view of the document, rather. It's the same document. And on the left, I'll make it mine. And I'll just zoom in on Michael's too, so that they look the same. So since I gave Michael editing privileges, if he wanted to come in here and say, I don't like this word, he could comment on it, since he also has commenting privileges, since editor gives you everything. And he could say, he's going to tag me, so he'll say at Adam. I think choices would be a better word here. And he's going to assign that to me and click assign. And if I come back over into Adam's account, I'll see that the word consideration is highlighted. If I left click on it, gonna scroll over a little bit here, I can see that Michael left this comment to me. I can reply to it. So let's just say I decide to do what he suggested. I go in here and change it to choices. And click OK. If you come back over to Michael, he can click the check mark here to kind of clear out that comment. So that's the overview of the most basic type of sharing. You're just sharing it with one person and you have three different levels. Let's go back to just my account. We'll go back to the share button. And you see here it says people and groups. So I have some groups set up so that we can see that. I'll actually go back out of here right now. And we'll go to any app really where you can see these nine dots. If I left click on that, scroll down to groups. I have a few groups here. Let's use the one called classroom teachers. Let's go back to the doc. We'll try to share it. And we'll type classroom teachers. There it is. So it comes up. It looks like it has its own email address, which probably does. You could probably email the people in here as a group. You have the same option to notify people. And anything that you change here is going to affect everyone that is in this group. So you can add or delete people using the group functionality that we had just looked at, and they'll dynamically come into this group and be able to view this document. So if you share it with classroom teachers, one of the teachers decides to leave the school, take them out of the group, they can't see the document anymore. So that covers sharing with groups. Let's bring that dialogue up again and take a look at it. There's one more thing to talk about here. Because I'm using a Google Workspace account, which is a paid account, let's left click on editor, and you can give someone temporary access. We'll go to that, and then you can give them access that specifies on a certain day. But it only works for the comment in the view only. And again, you're only seeing this option because I have a Google Workspace account. So if you're doing something where you want to expire access, probably look into paying for your Google account. So we've covered sharing with people in groups. Now the other type of sharing is sharing with a link, and this is a pretty different concept. And what this does is creates a link at the document level. So if you were to follow this link, no matter who you are, what we do below here will be controlled for everyone using the link. Okay, so you're not naming specific people anymore. So for this entire link that leads to this document, it's either how it is right now, which is restricted to only people added, or you can drop this down and restrict it to only people at your organization. So this is the name of my company, or anyone with the link. So we'll skip over organization. I think that's pretty self-explanatory. If we left click on anyone with the link, anyone that you give this link to will be able to view it or comment, or you can make them a full editor. So this last option, if you click on that, let's copy the link and we're going to bring up a new browser window. It's called an incognito window, meaning that the web doesn't know who I am right now. So I could be anyone. We'll paste that link into here and you'll see it doesn't know who I am, but it let me in. I'm not even signed into a Google account right now, but I could come in here and do 555555 and edit this document. It could be useful if you're sharing with a lot of people and they don't want to set up Google accounts and maybe there's nothing very private in here. You can use this option. It's a pretty low chance that someone's going to find this on the web and sabotage it. If you look at the URL, it's a very long string of random characters that are meant to be not really guessable by a human being. So we'll close that out. And that covers the basic options of how to share a document from inside of Google Docs. Now, another important way that you can share that gives you some more flexibility is inside of Google Drive. So Google Drive is what holds your Google Docs and your spreadsheets and any other files that you choose. But if you're using a Workspace account, what you can do, you can use a shared drive. So if I expand this option, I have drives in here that you control the sharing based on the entire folder level. So if you had 20 documents that you wanted to share with one group of people, you'd want to do it in a shared drive. If you drop down this menu from the shared drive, you can view the members, and all of these people can see all of the documents that come in and out. It just happens to be the same two people because I have a little account that I do these tutorials on. But if you have large groups and you're managing multiple documents for different uses, using the shared drive sometimes could be a lot easier than just sharing from inside of Google Docs. So the video that you see on your screen right now will give you a more in-depth analysis of shared drives and how they work. So I'll see you over in that video. Thanks for watching.